then 7, 3, comma 3 plus root 2, then 3 plus 2 root 2, and so on. Again we are calculating the phase difference B, T. This is first term, this is second term, this is the third term. The solution is what? D is equal to T2 minus T1, means 3 plus root 2, this is second term, minus first term, this is 3. 3 and 3 get cancelled, you get only the root 2. Again, the next, D is equal to T3 minus T2. Again, 3 plus 2 root 2, minus, in bracket, because there are 2 terms, so we are writing in the bracket. So, 3 plus 2 root 2 minus 3 plus root 2. Yeah. This sign is minus, so inner sign is also get changed when we solve the bracket. 3 minus 3, it will get deleted. And 2 root 2 minus root 2. 2 root 2 minus root 2. That will be a minus root 2. So, we get the difference is the same. So it is an AP, and D is what? Root 2. Fixed difference is what? Root 2. Then 8th example. Example number 8. In the same question number 1. 127, 132, 137, and so on. Again, this is the T1, this is the T2, and this is the T3. So, D is equal to what? T2 minus T1. Means 132 minus T1, 127. The difference is the 5. Again, T3 minus T2, not T1. Therefore, 137 minus 132. Again, difference is a 5. So, the common difference is what? Same. The common difference is the same, so according to condition of an AP, the given sequence is an AP, and common difference D is equal to what? 5. D is equal to what? 5. So we solve the question number 1, total question number 1. So we are solving the question number 2. Question number 2. What is that question? Write an AP whose first term is a A and common difference is a D in each of the following. Question number 2. A is given. What is the A? A is given 10 and D is equal to what? 5. So, they said that find out the AP. Find out AP. Arithmetic progression of the don't mind easily. Therefore, A is what? 10, and A is also equal to the T1. So, value of the first term is what? 10. The first term is what? 10. Then, second term. Second term, how it will be calculated? T2 is equal to what? A first term plus the fixed common difference D. Means 10 plus common difference is a 5, therefore T2 is equal to what? 15. Then T3. Here we are doing, we are finding out the next term by adding the fixed difference or a common difference in the previous term, means T2 plus D. Therefore 15 plus 5, that is a 20. So we get the AP starting from first term, that is a 10. Then after 15, then after 25, 20, then after 25, and so on. So we have this solution. This AP, 10, 15, 20, and 25. Then second sub question number 2, second sub question. A's value is a minus 3. A value is a minus 3 and D value is a 0. A's value is a minus 3 and D's value is a 0. A is also equal to T1. First term A denoted by A. So A is equal to T1 is equal to what? Minus 3. Then
we want to calculate the T2. T2 means we will add the fifth, the common difference in the previous term, means minus 3 plus 0, that is the minus 3. Then T3, again previous term is the minus 3. We add the D in it, it is a 0, so it is a minus 3. So we get continuously same number, minus 3, minus 3, first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and so on. These are our AP, that is our answer. Then, sub question third. Then, sub question number third. A's value is given minus 7, and D's value is given 1 upon 2, or it is also if 1 upon 2 means 1 half is written as 0.5. Instead of it, we will take this value. So, T1 is equal to A is equal to what? Minus 7. Okay. Then, T2 is what? The previous means T1 plus D means minus 7 plus what? The fixed difference is what? 0.5. So we are taking a subtraction, 7 minus 0.5, that is a 6.5, and higher number sign is what? Minus. Therefore, T2 is what? Minus 6.5. Then you are finding out the T3. T3 is what? The previous term, which is that previous term T2 plus the fixed difference D. T2 is what? Minus 6.5 plus fixed difference is a 0.5. Again, taking a subtraction, we get 6.5. Minus 0.5, that is a 6.0. Bigger, higher number sign is what? Minus. So we get the value of a T3 is equal to what? 6.0. And so on, we are calculating. So we get the AP is equal to what? Starting from first number, that is a minus 7, then minus 6.5, then minus 6.0. Then we are writing back. Orally calculation, that is 5.5, then minus 5.0, and so on. So we get that answer. Then third, in the same question, fourth sub question, that is A is equal to minus 1, 4. A is equal to minus 1.25. And D is equal to what? 3. D is equal to what? 3. Therefore, A's value is equal to the T1 is equal to minus 1.25. So we want to calculate the T2. T2 means what? Previous term, that is a T1 plus D. What is that value? Minus 1.25 plus fixed difference is a 3. So by subtracting it, means 3.00. It is written also 3.00, and this is written as 1.25. Taking a subtraction, that is 1.75. That is 1.75. But sign of a big higher number is a plus, so it is not written. So we get the value of T2 is equal to 1.75. The next T3 is equal to what? The previous term plus D means 1.75 plus this 3 means 4.75. So we get a value of T1, T2, and T3. So the AP is what? First, minus 1.25. Then second is what? 1.75. Then 4.75, and so on. We get that AP. Then fifth sub question. What will give one value of A? A is equal to 6, and D is equal to what? D is equal to what? Minus 3. So again, A is equal to T1 is equal to 6. Then T2 is equal to what? Previous term, T1 plus the D, means 6 plus in bracket. This is negative value, so we are writing in the bracket. By solving the bracket, 6 plus minus minus 3, that is the 3. So T2 is equal to what? 3. T1 is, we get 6, that is a, T2 is a 3, then again T3 is equal to what? T2 plus D. T2 is what? 3 plus D is a minus 3. Plus minus minus 3 minus 3, that is a 0. Therefore, T3 is equal to what? This is a value of a T3. T3 is what? 0. So, and AP is what? Starting from 6, then 3, then 0, and so on. So we got the AP. Then next is A is equal to minus 19, 6. A is equal to what? A is equal to what? Minus 19, 6, 1. 6 of the question. And D is equal to what? Minus 4. So, again, T1 is equal to A is equal to what? The given value, T1 is equal to A is equal to what? Minus 6. T2 is equal to what? Previous term, means T1 plus D. What is the T? T1 minus 16 plus D. This minus sign, so they are written in the bracket. By solving the bracket, minus 16 plus minus minus 4. Therefore, minus 16 minus both signs are the same. So, it is the addition and higher number sign is a minus. So, T2's value is what? We get minus 20. Then T3, T2's value we get, that is a minus 20. Then, T3 is equal to what? Previous term, means T2 plus again D, means minus 20 plus D, in bracket, minus 4. Therefore, minus 20 plus minus minus, that is minus 4. Both are the same sign, so that is the addition, and the higher number sign is what? Minus. So we get the AP. AP is what? Minus 16, then after minus 20, then after minus 24, and so this is our AP. Sub question. Okay. So the question number 3, we will solve that in the next section. Or we are solving here question number 3. Find out the first term and the common difference. Find out the first term and the common difference. First sub question. 5, 1, minus 3, and so on. Therefore, this is the first term, this is the second term, this is the third term. First term is also denoted by A, it is what? 5. So we get the value of A is equal to what? 5. Then we want to calculate the common difference, means difference between the two consecutive terms, T2 minus T1. What is the value of T2? It is 1 minus 5. So difference is a 4 and higher sign is a minus 4. So we get the value of D is equal to what? Minus 4. Then second sub question, and question number 3. Second, what is the given? 0.6, 0.9, that sequence is given, 1.2, and so on. So we want to calculate, to find out the value of T1, means A, T1, this is T2, this is a T3. So T1 is also called the A, that is a 0.6, so we get the value of A. Then we want to calculate the pitch difference, means T2 minus T1, there will be a 0.9, and this is a minus 0.6. 0.9 minus 0.6 means 0 minus 0, and 9 minus 6, it is a 3, means we get the difference 0.3. D is equal to what? 0.3, and A is equal to what? 0.6. Then third example. 127, 135, 143 and so on. Again, this is the T1, this is the T2 and this is the T3. So, solution is what? T1 is equal to A is a 127.
We want to calculate the fixed difference.
We want to calculate the fixed difference between them. So, D is equal to what? T2 minus T1. So, 135 is the T2 and T1 is what? 127, the difference is the 8. So, we get D is equal to 8 and A's value is 127. That is our answer.
Then, fourth one. Then, fourth one. One by four, 3 by 4, 5 by 4, and so on. Again, this is the T1, this is the T2, and this is the T3. T1 is also called the A. So, value of A we get, value of A is 1 by 4. Then, the difference between the two consecutive terms, T2 minus T1, means that is a 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. So, LCM is what? The denominator is the same. So, it is written only one time. Therefore, 3 minus 1, we get 2 by 4, 2 was a 2, 2 are. So, the fixed difference is what? 1 up. So, we get the D is equal to 1 by 2 and A's value is what? A's value is what? 1 by 4. That is our answer. Then fifth. Okay, there is no fifth sub question. So we solve the whole exercise. In the next section, we solve the next exercise 3.2. Thank you.